you guys, and welcome back to another SDOM moment. I'm going to try to make this really quick for you guys. But today is a different type of video. And we're just going to jump right into it. I'm going to share a story with you all that happened to me short of 20 years ago. But it is a very important story. There's a lesson that can be learned from this. And so I'm going to share with you guys the one and only time that I've ever heard the audible voice of God. Like I've actually heard the Lord's voice in my ear. As clear as I am speaking to you, I heard him in my ear. So we're going to talk about it. All right. Before we move forward with this video, this can go one or two ways or both. The first way it could go is there'll be a group of people that watch this video for kicks and giggles. However, there will be a second group of people that will watch this video, and in some way, shape, or form, it will lead them to God. And that is the purpose of this video. I do understand that, and I am deciding to move forward and share my story anyhow. Okay. Now, three questions that I thought while I studied and God led me to share this story. First question is, why am I sharing this story? And the simple answer is, I had a different life before surrendering to Christ, as all believers do. We all have a life, and then we are surrendering to Christ, our life changes, right? But it doesn't change instantly. It starts from the inside. Psalms 145:4-13 reads, "Let each generation tell its children of your mighty acts. Let them proclaim your power. I will meditate on your majestic, glorious splendor and your wonderful miracles. Your awe-inspiring deeds will be on every tongue. I will proclaim your greatness. Everyone will share the story of your wonderful goodness. They will sing with joy about your righteousness. The Lord is merciful and compassionate, slow to get angry and filled with unfailing love. The Lord is good to everyone. He showers compassion on all his creation. All of your works will thank you, Lord, and your faithful followers will praise you. They will speak of the glory of your kingdom. They will give examples of your power. They will tell about your mighty deeds and about the majesty and glory of your reign. For your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. You rule throughout all generations." That's why I'm telling my story. Okay. I had a life before Christ, before surrendering my life. And so Psalms reminds me that I'm supposed to tell of the goodness of God and how powerful he is and how his love saved me. Okay. Second question is, what do I want to come from me sharing this story? Well, it's simple: to lead people to Christ. God will take it from there. Okay. I am only a vessel. That's it. And God will lead and transform those people from the inside out so that they can tell their stories of how God has worked in their lives and so forth and so on. Third question: do I want to share this story? Being transparent? No. No, I don't. But God didn't suggest that I share this story. I'm commanded to share this story, right? So I don't have a choice. And life is all about perspective. And so if I look at me sharing this story from a negative point of view, then am I really making it about God, or am I making it about me? Okay. This isn't about how I feel. This isn't about what I want. I love God. And so because I love him, I kneel before him. Therefore, I can stand before anyone and I can share my story without shame. Okay? And to God be the glory. All right? So now that we have those three questions out of the way, if you have more, leave them below. We're going to go ahead and get started. So again, this story takes place short of 20 years ago. This was a very long time ago, okay? Short of 20 years ago, I was at a place in my life where I was reckless. I was out there in the world. I was out there. But I wasn't too far out there, so not too much on the out there. Not too much, but I was out there, right? And I was dibbling and dabbling in things, you know, that I knew better than to dibble and dabble in, okay? And this one particular night, out partying, hanging out with people I have no business hanging out with, just in the world, okay? And I, you know, had been drinking. I was just should not have even been in that environment. And it came down to this one particular moment, right? But let me set it up for you. Now, this day, I had prepped for this party, right? And so I knew what was going to be there. I knew who was going to be there, and this continued to go anyway, right? And so, mind you, I have always known that it was a calling on my life. Like, I've always known, you know, I'm a child of God. I've always been a believer in my heart. You know, I've always felt God's hand on my life. So, you know, yes, I was out there partying, but I was also going to church. I was reading the word. Same things that I'm doing now, but I was lukewarm. Okay? I was lukewarm. And, you know, so I hadn't completely given my life over to the Lord, right? Not in my heart. Like, I would, you know, go to church on Sunday, but Saturday night, I was, you know, partying. I was out there. And so, you know, I get to this party and I am just like having a great time, so I think, and I am enjoying myself. And it comes down to this one particular moment where I have to use the bathroom so bad. Like, the only way that I can describe it is that I had to use it so bad that I could have gone to the bathroom myself. Like, that's how bad I had to use it. I couldn't hold it. It was like, you know, trickling out, because you guys have to understand the intensity of my bladder at that moment. Like, I had to use the bathroom. I almost didn't even make it to the bathroom. Like, but, and I don't know why I just didn't go to the bathroom. It could have been I was just having so much fun. I was just holding it. I was ignoring it. I don't know, which is not good, by the way. Don't do that. Anyway, get to the bathroom, right? Now, I get to the bathroom And in the bathroom, I'm by myself. So I have this moment of quietness. And still under the influence, like, but I'm still understanding what is going on. But there's a moment of brief soberness. And I pull my pants down, get ready to squat over the toilet. And as soon as I allow my muscles to release myself, you know what you're doing is wrong. Oh my Lord. When I tell you clear as day, as how you hear me speaking to you in my right ear, I'm literally squatting over the toilet. Because mind you, I have to use the bathroom so bad. I can't hold it. I get ready to lean over the toilet. Soon as I get ready to use it, boom. You know what you're doing is wrong. When I tell you I could have had a heart attack, the sound of the voice scared me so bad I could have died. Immediately fell over right there. Boom. Pants down and all. I could have died. That's how frightened I was by the voice. I had never heard this voice before. And I want to set it up for you. It's like as if I picture it in my head. He's leaned. Soon as I'm getting ready to use it, he leaned down. He leaned down. You know what you're doing is wrong. And I was stuck. I was frozen. My heart was beating so fast. I didn't even pee. I did not pee. Remember I told you how bad I had to pee. I couldn't hold it. I could have peed on myself. I almost didn't even make it to the bathroom. I had been holding it for a minute. Nothing came out. That's how frightened I was. Because I knew it was the voice of God. I knew it was him. My hands were shaking. I was stuck for a minute. Because it was my mind trying to process, okay, am I tripping? Like, wait a minute now. I knew that was God. Okay? I want y'all to understand how frightened the voice of God sounded to me in my ear at that moment. It wasn't he didn't yell. There was nothing negative about it. There was nothing. It was a soft, still yet powerful sound. And it's almost like I could feel his breath on my ear. That's how close it was. It scared the crap out of me. And he was right. What I was doing was wrong. I didn't have no business being in that situation. But God allowed that small moment of quiet time away from the music, away from the people, away from that environment, that small window where I was alone by myself. He took that opportunity to speak to me. Okay, it's not over. I was so afraid that I ran out of the bathroom. And I immediately started saying, God's getting ready to come back. He's getting ready to come back. And I was petrified. I'm looking out the window, looking for the sky. I'm like, is the sky about to crack? Like, I'm like, I am tripping. Like, that's how afraid I was. I opened up the door. I'm looking out the door. I'm like, I'm looking to see if people are running around. Like, because something is not right. How? There's no way that that was God talking to me. Like, I never heard that voice before or after that moment. I still haven't. Now, God has spoken to me in other ways, but his voice, himself in my ear, never before or after. Okay. That moment has always stuck with me. I've never forgotten how his voice sounds. And to continue in transparency, there have been moments in my life where I have been in situations after that where I knew I shouldn't have been in, and I was looking for his voice. There have been times where I would be praying and I had asked God, talk to me the way that you talked to me that night. I want to hear your voice the way that I heard you that night. I have prayed to hear his voice again and I have not. Okay, so we're going to fast forward. Remember I told you, this was like almost 20 years ago. This was a minute ago. About 2 weeks ago, I'm in the bed, read my word, right? And it's so interesting because I was looking for something else. And I came across this verse. And I want to share it with you all, okay? So the first verse I'm going to share with you is from Job, right? So let's go to Job. Okay, so we're going to start at Job, the book of Job, and we're going to read from chapter 33, verse 14. And it says, "For God speaks again and again, though people do not recognize it, he speaks in dreams, in visions of the night, when deep sleep falls on people as they lie in their beds." Boom. Stop right there. Mind you, this was 2 weeks ago. The story I just told you about was almost 20 years ago. So I'm studying my word and I'm, you know, looking for something else, and I come across this scripture. So I'm like, yeah, you know, I can identify with that. You know, God does speak through dreams and he can speak through other people. He speaks in many ways. It's not just one way, right? But then the next verse, it says, and we're still in Job chapter 33. The next verse says, 16. The next verse is 16. "He whispers in their ears and terrifies them with warnings." I'm going to reread that because I want somebody to catch it. In Job chapter 33, it says, "For God speaks again and again, though people do not recognize it. He speaks in dreams and visions of the night when deep sleep falls on people as they lay in their beds." Yes. I'm sure a lot of us can identify with that. Yes. The next verse says he whispers. Remember? He whispers in their ears and terrifies them. I was terrified with warnings. He was warning me. God was warning me, you know what you're doing is wrong. I'm literally, if y'all could see the hairs on my arm, my heart is beating so fast because it's taking me back to that moment. I heard the voice of God. And I'm going to tell you, I'm so thankful. I'm so blessed that God chose me. Me. Little old me. I heard him. I was terrified. Remember, I told you I couldn't even use the bathroom. I had to pee so bad. I had to use the bathroom so bad. Nothing came out. That's how terrified I was. But yet, his word is telling, it's confirming. So, 2 weeks ago, I'm reading my word. God confirms that that was him talking to me almost 20 years ago. That's him confirming it to me. Yes, Kyla, that was me. He whispers in their ears and terrifies them with warnings. I had never read this in the Bible before. I'm not going to sit up and act like I know the Bible from front to back. I've already told y'all this is a spiritual journey for me. I just completely surrendered my life to Christ this year. This year. Like, not playing no games. This year, okay? And God is confirming himself to me from a situation that happened so long ago. Mind you, picture this. I'm in the bed reading this. I almost threw my Bible across the floor, across the room. I couldn't believe it. I said, I knew it. I knew that was you. I knew that was you. I knew it. So, needless to say, you know, a lot of my content is encouraging people to seek the Lord. And I love to share my experiences in real time because it's genuine, it's authentic, and I want y'all to know God is real. He is real. And it's never too late for the Lord to reach you. It's never too late to surrender. It's never too late to come to Him. Mind you, God spoke to me in a time where I was lost. I was in environments and situations, conversations that I have no business being in. But yet He still was able to reach me. Do you understand what I'm saying? He was still able to reach me. Let's go down to Acts 2 and 10. All right, here we go. The reason for me telling this story is because of Psalms 145, 4 through 13, but also because of Acts 2 and 17. And it says, in the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit upon all people. Your sons, your daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions, and your old men will dream dreams. In those days, I will pour out my spirit even on my servants, men and women alike, and they will prophesy. And I will cause wonders in heavens above and signs on the earth below. Blood and fire and clouds of smoke. The sun will become dark and the moon will turn blood red before that great and glorious day of the Lord arrives. But everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. That is why I'm telling this story. I want you all to know that it doesn't matter what you have gone through in your life. It doesn't matter what you have been through. It don't matter how far you think you have strayed from the Lord. As long as your heart says yes, right? As long as your heart says yes, God will do a work in your life and He will change your life around. I do not care. And so a lot of my content is built on encouraging people, unbelievers and believers, encouraging people to know that if God can do it for me, He will do it for you. And I haven't even gotten into everything. I have so many testimonies. I've come so far. And I cannot allow shame, guilt, or me getting in my own head stop me from sharing God's grace and mercy that He's had over my life. I'm sure that you have stories. It's a lot of us could be dead and gone, but God. I thank God every day that I didn't die in the world. I didn't die not knowing. I thank God every day. I could have died trying to feed my flesh, but God. So, remember I told you at the beginning of this video, it can go one or two ways. There'll be a group of people that look at this video and they get their little kicks and giggles out of it, and that's fine. But then there's going to be that group of people that this video reaches, and they're going to say, hey, I heard the voice of God. I didn't know that was him. I was in a situation where I wasn't supposed to be in, and God saved me. Or I'm out here living reckless. Let me open up my Bible. Let me see who this man is. Let me see what he can do for me. Let me see how I can live according to his word. Because I'm tired. I'm tired of living like this. I can't. I'm getting too old for this. The Bible says, seek ye the kingdom of God and his righteousness first. And then everything else after that will be unto you. We have to get to a place in our life where we place God first. Not second, not third. First. He is our guide. He knows all. He sees all. We don't. He only allows us to see but so much. We are not in control. And so once we understand that and we wrap our minds around that, to literally let go of the control that we think we have and give it to God that we know he has, things will begin to work out much easier and better for us. So, just wanted to let you all know that I heard the voice of God. Okay? And I didn't immediately change my life the next day. It took time, but it was God's grace and mercy that kept me to get this far to share my testimony. All right, you guys, that is it. That is all. That is your SEOM moment. I pray that you all have a blessed day. Bye. Thank you for watching.